In this video, I'm going to show you how I do my keyword research for this YouTube channel and all of my websites, and I'm going to explain what keyword research is in a bit, but first I want to let you know that what I'm going to show you in this video is probably single-handedly the biggest contributing factor to my online success, so I highly recommend you watch the whole video and pay close attention. Okay, so what is keyword research? My definition of keyword research is understanding what people are searching for online and crafting your content around it so that you show up in search results. Keyword research is just a subset of search engine optimization, or SEO, which itself is the process of improving traffic to a website from search engines. Now, I want to be very clear from the start here that it's always very important to keep in mind when creating online content that you are creating content for humans and not search engines. When you boil it down, the main purpose of a search engine is to connect someone searching for a topic with the most relevant websites about that topic. Okay, so as long as you understand that, let's move on to the topic of this video, which is keyword research. And for my keyword research, I use a tool called SEMrush. Now, SEMrush is a massive suite of tools with many features, but the only one I use is the Keyword Magic tool. Keeping in mind that I'm going to show you how to use the Keyword Magic tool for free, SEMrush plans are not cheap and start at $120 per month, which can be as low as $100 per month if you pay annually. And while I find extreme value in the Keyword Magic tool, I still don't think it's worth $100 a month. So how do you get it for free? Well, there is a free trial, which I have linked in the description below, that will give you access to all of SEMrush's extensive SEO features. It's definitely worth checking out, but that's not what this video is about. The secret keyword research hack that I want to share with you is the fact that you get 10 free keyword magic queries every single day. And even for someone like me who has 3 YouTube channels and over a dozen different websites, I'm able to work with this limitation, so I'm guessing it shouldn't be a problem for you either. So go ahead and sign up for a free SEMrush account and meet me here at the Keyword Magic Tool page. Let's go through an example of how to do basic keyword research. And for the sake of example, let's say you have a website that sells solar panels. Start out by thinking about what your potential website visitors or customers are typing into Google. Maybe solar panels, buy solar panel cost, or best solar panels. Let's start off very broad and use the Keyword Magic tool to see what kind of search volume solar panels sees on Google. And as you can see here, 165,000 people are searching for solar panels every month in the United States, which is a ton of potential traffic if your website was on the first page of Google. But over here, you'll see that there are 450 million search results for solar panels, so the chances of your website ranking on Google are slim to none. This is summarized in the keyword difficulty column with a score of 90 out of 100, which indeed means that it would be very difficult for your website to rank in the first 10 Google search results. The main goal here is to find keywords with relatively high search volume and a low number of search results. Since solar panels is a very broad search, let's be more specific and investigate RV solar panels, which has significantly less search results and a more reasonable but still high keyword difficulty. So as you can quickly see, the keyword difficulty values are in the 50s and 60s rather than the 80s and 90s as we saw before. It's still unlikely that you'll appear on the first page of Google if you target any of these keywords, so let's go even more specific and add the word roof to our keyword search. Now, each one of these keywords contains the word solar, panels, RV, and roof, and we now see very achievable keyword difficulty scores in the 20s, which means that you have a very good chance of ranking on the first page of Google if you target these keywords. One of your best keywords in this list is attaching solar panels to RV roof without drilling, which has a monthly search volume of 170 and only 28,000 search results. Let's confirm this by typing this keyword phrase into Google, and indeed there are only about 30,000 search results, which let's remember to compare this to the much harder to rank for keyword phrase solar panels, which has 381 million search results. So again, the goal with keyword research is to find keywords with a relatively high search volume and low number of search results. And when you do this, you can take these keywords and strategically put them into your blog post title, content, relevant image file names, alt texts, and meta descriptions. By doing this, you have a much better chance of getting the exact people who are searching for those keyword phrases to click into your website. And from there, if you're selling something, you can lead those potential customers to your product pages. Remember, you get 10 free Keyword Magic Tool searches per day, so make sure you use them wisely. If there's one thing I want you to take away from this video, it would be how important it is to understand what your potential website visitors are searching for. Without this knowledge, it's pretty much like you're shooting in the dark with your fingers crossed. So I highly recommend you take the time to put yourself in your audience's shoes to better understand them. We talked a lot about solar panels in this video, and I am currently living in an RV with solar panels on my roof. So if you want to find out more about how I attached solar panels to my roof without drilling, check out this video from my friend's new channel. Otherwise, I have this playlist here with some of my best SEO tips.